Now I will be drawing the SF diagram. For that I have to draw the beam once again. So this overhanging beam, I will draw it again. This is the beam which is given, supported at A and B. Now I have to draw the shear force diagram. For that, I will first be projecting the points downward. For drawing shear force diagram, the length of shear force diagram should be equal to the length of the beam. SF at point C, that is minus 10, so downward. (10 kN). Now this 10 kN will remain constant between C to A because there is no load between them. So here 10 kN is constant. Next, at point A, the value is plus 6.71 kN. So from negative it will go into positive. Here I have 6.71 kN. Again, this will be constant between A to D since there is no load between A to D. Then at point D, the shear force is minus 17.29. So from positive it again goes back to negative 17.29, and this will remain constant between D to B since there is no load between D to B. Next, at point B, the shear force is plus 15. So from negative again it will go into positive region, having value 15 kN. So here is the shear force diagram which we have. I can write 10 here also, 10 kN. The 6.71 kN remains constant. So 6.71 kN. Here I have 17.29 kN, and this 15 kN is constant. Positive sign above the line, negative below the line. So this completes my shear force diagram. After completing shear force diagram, we will be going on to step number 3, that is bending moment calculations. Step number 3 is bending moment calculations. As we can see here we have an overhanging beam. So for overhanging beam, at the ends which are free, that is the end which is hanging, at point C, at point E, the bending moment will be 0. So here I can write it as, first of all, moment at C is equal to moment at E, that is equal to 0. Into the bracket I can write down, since it is overhanging beam. After this, I will calculate the bending moment at point A, B and D. First, starting with point A, and just before the calculation I will draw the sign convention. Clockwise moment to left and anticlockwise moment to the right are positive. Then anticlockwise moment to the left and clockwise moment to the right are negative. So these are my sign conventions. Based on this we will find the bending moment. So starting from point A, if I see here, to the left of A I have only one force, that is 10 kN, and it is producing moment in anti-clockwise direction. So if my section is at point A and this moment is in anti-clockwise direction, so anti-clockwise moment to the left is negative. So here I have moment at A is equal to, it is minus 10 into 2, because here I have minus 10 kilonewton downward and it is into 2 meter distance. So that is minus 20 kilonewton meter. Next, bending moment at point B. Moment at B is equal to, here if I take the section at B, to the right of that I have 15 kilonewton producing clockwise moment. So clockwise moment to the right is negative. So here I have 15 into 3 with a negative sign, that is minus 45 kilonewton meter. After that, moment at point D. So for that I can take either the left or right section. So moment at D will be equal to, if I take the section at D, to the left of it 10 kilonewton is anti-clockwise, so it has to be taken negative. So 10 into 6, that is minus 10 multiplied by 6. Next, I have your reaction at A whose value is 16.71 kilonewton. RB is 32.29 kilonewton. Now if I see here, 16.71 kilonewton will produce clockwise moment to the left, so it is positive. So 16.71 into 4. Therefore, I get bending moment at D is equal to 6.87 plus kilonewton meter. So here I have found the bending moment values at each of the points. With this, we can draw the bending moment diagram. At the free end, first of all, here I will be drawing a straight line, because straight line indicates the length of the diagram. Bending moment at C and E, they are zero. So moment at C is zero. Moment at E is equal to zero because they are overhanging beam. Now, moment at A is minus 20. So moment at A would be in the downward direction, 20 kilonewton meter. I will write the sign afterwards. Next, moment at B is equal to minus 45. So at B it is again negative 45 kilonewton meter. I'll write the sign. Then at D, the bending moment is plus 6.87. At D it is plus 6.87 kilonewton meter. Now I have to join these lines. Wherever we are getting shear force as a straight constant line, bending moment is an inclined line. Between A to D, shear force was a straight line, so bending moment is an inclined line. Between D to B, it is again straight line, so bending moment is inclined. And between B to E, it is straight line, so bending moment is inclined. Positive and negative.